Hello everyone, my name is Melanie. Welcome back to A Slice of Heaven Homestead. Today I wanted to show you how to make your own pizza. Now, I did not make my own pizza until about 2 years ago. We had just moved here to Japan and found that pizza was very expensive and it was weird. I think one of the weirdest pizzas that we discovered here is a mayonnaise corn shrimp pizza. No, just plain straight pepperoni pizzas anywhere in sight. So I had to figure out a way to make my own pizza. Now the recipe I'm going to share with you today, it'll take about 2 hours. Most of that is just waiting for the dough to rise. But overall cost of an entire large pizza, it's about $5. Now I'll make sure to have all the ingredients that you need for this recipe down in the description below. For this recipe, you will need 1 1/3 cup of warm water. 2 1/4 teaspoon of active dry yeast, 1/2 teaspoon of sugar, 1 teaspoon of salt, 3 tablespoons of olive oil, and 3 1/2 cups of all-purpose flour. Now first, you want to take your warm water. You don't want your water to be hot. You don't want it to be hot because it will end up killing the yeast. So just a nice warm water, like a bath. And you want to add your 1/2 teaspoon of sugar and your packet of yeast. Stir that up really well and we'll wait 10 minutes. It's been about 10 minutes and it looks nice and frothy. That means that the yeast in there is thriving and doing what it needs to do. Now we're going to start adding our other ingredients. Teaspoon of salt. Three tablespoons of olive oil. Now I'm going to add this first cup of flour and then stir it up real good. And we'll just go ahead and stir in all the rest of this. Now, if it doesn't turn into a big ball of dough right away, don't worry about it. We'll be kneading it and it'll be just fine. Now, you want to make sure you have a clean, dry surface. Now as I'm kneading this, I'm going to go ahead and turn my oven on just to warm it up. When it gets warm in the oven, I'm going to turn that oven off. I'm going to be resting my dough in the oven on a baking sheet with a nice damp towel draped over my bowl. Now this dough, it's a little sticky, but it's not an unmanageable sticky, and it's not too hard. If the dough was too hard and flaky, you could add a little bit more water to it. Now I'm going to add just a little bit of olive oil to my bowl. And you want to make sure to coat this dough all around so it doesn't dry out. That oven is warm but not hot, so I'll go ahead and turn it off. I'll place my bowl on the cookie sheet just to protect the plastic, because I don't know how warm the metal is in there. I don't want my plastic bowl melting on the oven rack. And then I've gotten this nice and damp and I've wrung it out, and that should keep it nice and moist. Now again, you don't want the temperature in your oven getting too hot, because you don't want it to kill that active yeast. You need the yeast to live in order for it to rise, to fluff up. So I'm gonna go ahead and leave this in here resting for about 10 minutes, and then I'm gonna go ahead and knead it a little bit more. So it's been resting in the oven for about 10 minutes. We're gonna take it out and we're just gonna knead it for about 2 minutes. Put a little bit more olive oil on it. Now we're going to return this back to the warm oven for 60 minutes. I'm going to set my timer for 30 minutes, and I'm going to check and make sure that it's still warm in that oven. If it's cooled down quite a bit, I'll turn it on for about 1 minute until the temperature rises in that oven just a little bit. Don't turn your oven on and forget it. I can guarantee it's a nasty mess. Now for this next part, you're going to need garlic salt, oregano, either tomato sauce or pizza sauce, cornmeal, olive oil, and your toppings. Now I do 3 to 4 cups of cheese. We like lots of cheese. So first off, we're going to take our pizza dough out of the oven, and we are going to immediately preheat this to 470 degrees. So we're going to take our pizza pan, and you can also use a 9x13 baking sheet if you don't have a circle pan, that's okay. And we're going to lightly sprinkle some of this cornmeal. That's to help the pizza dough not to stick on the pan. Watch that rose. Flip it over. I'm just going to take a little bit of olive oil. Make an indent right there. Take a little bit of olive oil to help me spread this around. That way my hands don't get too sticky with dough. Now I'm using more of a sideways motion. I'm not trying to push down really hard. Now the olive oil will also help the sauce not to sink into the dough and make it mushy. Okay, so now to add your sauce. You can add as much as you want or as little as you want. We like a lot of sauce. And you can sprinkle your garlic salt. Again, this is just a taste. Some people like a lot of salt, some people don't like as much. If I had to guess, I would say it's about a half a teaspoon. Same with the oregano. And then we'll go ahead and add our cheese. Now for the toppings. So when that gets up to the right temperature, we are going to put that in the oven. Just on the middle rack. You want to make sure that it gets an even heat from the bottom and the top. We'll set that for 15 minutes. Now with two hungry teenagers in the house, I did have a second batch of dough going. So while this first pizza is cooking in the oven, I went ahead and put all my toppings on the second pizza. It's so simple. Okay, it's time to take that pizza out. Now I did leave this pizza in for 16 minutes instead of 15. I found that the more toppings you put on, the more time it needs in the oven. But I know 15 minutes will be perfect for that plain pepperoni pizza. Now we just want to let it rest for about 5 minutes. It's been about 5 minutes, it's time to cut the pizza. Now I just give it that time to rest so that the cheese isn't super gooey. And there you are, a perfect pizza. So guys, thank you for joining me today and learning how to make your very own homemade pizza. Spread a little kindness and encourage one another today. If you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe. And until next time, we hope you find your slice of heaven too.